Hi, this is Ali and you're watching the ChatGPT Features video series on Learn Awesome. In this video, we shall discuss data analysis with ChatGPT. ChatGPT gives you the amazing ability to analyze both structured and unstructured data with you instructing it in natural language. In age of data science and machine learning, this is the next level thing. Just a few years ago, analyzing dataset was core dominion of data scientists, who had to jump through hoops writing Python code and struggling to get key insights from datasets using their learning, expertise, and experience. Extracting information from unstructured data was a dream next-level skill of most data scientists. Just preparing the data to perform any meaningful operation was a domain in itself. With ChatGPT, many of these operations are now a few commands away. Let's begin with data cleanup. Given any structured data, since ChatGPT can identify NANs and outliers, it can help you clean up the data. It is as simple as few instructions to clean up given data, and it would come up with the required code to do so. If you have data science background, pre-processing and data cleanup is a big field and consume a considerable percentage of effort. You can even ask recommendations from ChatGPT for methods to use for outlier and NAN removal. You don't always remove missing data. You replace it with values using statistical inferences. ChatGPT can write Python code to perform operations. All the above actions can be requested in form of Python code and ChatGPT would generate the code. You do need to pick and choose the strategy, for example, encoding with one-hot encoding or label encoding, or removing missing data or replacing with some strategy. You need to stay in control even though the grunt work is being outsourced. Quality of inferences would be directly affected by the choices you make. You need to be aware of the methods you are applying for data cleanup, otherwise you can't expect premium quality cleanup. Using ChatGPT can help, but does not absolve you of responsibility of knowing what is going on with the data. Choosing the wrong strategy or letting ChatGPT make a decision on your behalf can directly affect the analysis going forward, as each strategy has its pros and cons, and there is a trade-off involved with each method. It just makes cleanup faster for you. The decisions and outcomes are still yours. Many other basic operations like scaling values, normalization, and outlier detection can also be performed really quickly with ChatGPT help. It can even write Python code for model selection, parameter tuning, and then graphing and charting. Other operations like mean, median, and other row column specific operation or information extraction can be performed. It can even write SQL queries you can run on structured datasets to extract insights from the data. You can do feature engineering where you create new features from existing information to perform deeper analysis. Rich in terminology, ChatGPT can extract a lot of statistics from data and can help analyze a particular attribute. Extracting meaningful insights from structured as well as unstructured data is a true game changer ability of ChatGPT. Given a dataset, either by you or available online, extracting key insight is just a prompt away. You can prompt further to lean more towards particular aspect of analysis. It can answer questions about the data, like which product had most sales or which manufacturers made the most revenue given a product sales data. Evaluate datasets that are available publicly without even providing one by providing their URL. Or if it is a general topic, let ChatGPT figure out itself where to get the data from. As an example, you can analyze some company financial information by just asking for key information, risks, financial statements, etc. Without needing to provide hand-picked datasets, ChatGPT would be able to do that for you. You ask for projections, risk assessments, etc. Keep in mind it's not real-time, because ChatGPT training was done more than a year ago, so the data might be stale. You can even perform SWOT analysis in certain situations and be amazed at quality output that is produced. With vast knowledge at its disposal, identifying strengths and weaknesses of a product or company against competition requires diverse information about that environment they operate in. And being a large language model, ChatGPT has access to all such information and can do brilliant analysis and identify issues and opportunities you would struggle even with most brilliant scientists and researchers at your disposal. Are you struggling to figure out what is the next operation you need to ask ChatGPT to perform on dataset or domain? Well, why bother? Why not just ask ChatGPT to provide recommendations on how to analyze that data? It can even list potential questions that can be explored with this dataset. Pick the ones you find most valuable and ask away. You're living in a wonderful time, right? You need to be in control of what answers you need from dataset. However, sometimes it's not possible. In that case, you can leverage the recommendations from ChatGPT, or you can brainstorm with it. You need to nudge it in the direction that most interests you. Ask it to list different angles to explore the data, and then use iterative prompting for research methods to individually attack the data with those suggested approaches. ChatGPT can also aid you with creating charts and graphs for the information it has about a topic or dataset. If it can't plot the graph, it would provide you Python code to do so. There are a bunch of operations you can perform on unstructured data and information available online as well. For example, extracting name of characters from stories, extracting sentiment from customer reviews, classifying text based on certain attributes, etc. ChatGPT also provides you the ability to create structured information from unstructured data. Finally, you can ask ChatGPT to provide you code it did to perform any of the operations, and it would happily provide that code to you. We just briefly explored the analysis feature in this video. It's a big topic which requires its own series. But for now, that was all for that introductory video on that feature. Please give a thumbs up and share if you liked the content, and subscribe to be notified of upcoming content. Thank you.